So over the last couple of weeks, I've been doing quite a lot of renovation work to my children's bedrooms, and I'm just doing this video now just to show some of the electrical bits and pieces that we've done in there. Nothing's particularly fancy, but I just wanted to demonstrate some of the things that we have done. So we'll take you up there now. Coming upstairs into my daughter's bedroom, as you can see, it's not finished yet. There's still a lot of things still to do, all the skirtings put on, put new doors on, etc. And then we've also gone up into the attic space, and that's all been insulated and boarded. So that too now needs to be, that also needs to be finished. Now, one of the things I wanted to point out in here is, for this particular video, is the sockets. So you can see the makeup table here. And so there's a socket above, and then there's two double sockets below. Now, at the moment, both of these sockets are, all of these sockets should be dead. So the reason for that is you can see that there are some hair straighteners and some a hair dryer, and it's those sort of items of equipment that can cause, obviously they get very hot, so they can cause fires. So if my daughter was to forget to turn them off, what she can now do is, here we have a 20 amp double pole switch, and that 20 amp double pole switch controls the sockets underneath, and some sockets upstairs in the attic space as well. So the idea of that is that all we have done is a 20 amp to a 20 amp radial circuit, and so the radial circuit comes to the double pole switch, and then it simply then goes off to all of the sockets, etc. So just by pressing the switch, so it's obviously in the off position, turn it on, and you can see that the tester has now become live. We turn it off, and those sockets now become dead. So the idea is that anything that she has plugged in there, such as the hair straighteners, the hair dryers, will be turned off. Not all of the sockets in the attic space will be on that switch. There'll be two double sockets that are left permanently live. One is for the television, and one is for a fish tank. Obviously, those things don't want to be turned off. With modern day televisions that use the internet, every time the power gets cut to them, then they need to reset the internet. So that will be the sockets for the TV and for the fish tank will be permanently left live. There will be a socket next to her bed, which she'll probably use to plug in a phone charger. Again, that will be left, that one will be on the switch. So that won't just be left turned on.
Right, let me jump in now and do a wiring diagram with what Matt is up to. So he's wiring an A3 radial circuit in his house, so consuming it to the sockets that he's got there, and he's introduced a double pole switch. A3 radial wired in 2.5 mm² twin and CPC or twin and earth cables. Obviously the CPC, as always in our cables, is bare and needs to be identified with green sleeving. And he's fused at 20 amps in the consumer unit and additionally protected by an RCD rated at 30 milliamps or less. So that's what we've got for our standard A3 arrangement, but this double pole switch Matt's put in is a real clever trick, especially with his daughter and her bedroom. So 2.5 from the consumer unit to socket number 1, 2, 3, or however many Matt did before going through the double pole switch. As always with these wiring diagrams, the connections in here are not exactly as they would be in the consumer unit. We've got symbol for a fuse, overcurrent protection device, neutral, which would be your neutral bar or the top of maybe an RCBO, etc., and the earth terminal within the earth bar itself. So if I wire this 2.5 mm cable from the consumer unit to socket number 1, and then we'll go through our double pole switch and explain what's going on there. So our line conductor, this is going to look a little bit messy because obviously I'm going to keep crossing my conductors over as I go. So line conductor. Then we've got our neutral conductor, and then we've got our CPC coming out the actual earth bar itself. So up we come, and we've got our CPC. Remember, sometimes I like to just strike it yellow just to make it look like a CPC. So that's our first 2.5 mm² cable from the consumer unit to socket number one. Matt's likely to have chosen all twin socket outlets, and the terminations in the back are to suit. In this one, this would be line here, neutral, and there's two CPC terminations. Okay, so I've just shown a single socket for it. Now, he could have done two or three sockets before he went through the double pole switch. So let's have a look at the double pole switch next. So he's got something similar to this. This is just out of my garage, but it's got a switch on it. Okay, and when we turn it over, we've got supply, CPC, neutral, and line, and then load, neutral, line, and a CPC. So that's what we've got with our terminations there, okay? Now, I've done it slightly different here. I've done top and bottom, so this would be the supply, line, and neutral, CPC terminal, and then going out for my load here. It means that Matt can obviously turn off a number of socket outlets, which he described in the video itself. So we now bring from this socket here a 2.5 millimeter squared cable, and we bring it into our double pole switch. So let's start off, let's do the CPC first. I've made just one earth terminal in here. We'll strike that with yellow. So again, this is the CPC coming in the 2.5 mil cable. We've got our line conductor. So I bring out our line conductor into here, and we've got our neutral as well. So that becomes the 2.5 millimeter squared cable from whichever socket Matt determined to use that went through his double pole switch. Now, every socket off here now can be isolated. So by operating this switch, by when his daughter leaves her bedroom, she can turn off the lights as well as this switch. It will turn off the sockets around the dressing table area. Matt was a bit concerned she might leave on hair straighteners or something like that. So another 2.5 millimeter squared cable now from the load side feeds the sockets that Matt wants to turn off. So we'll come out of what I've made as my CPC terminal here, and we'll go across to here. Again, we'll just strike that yellow. I'd expect you to be using a ruler if you were copying this drawing out. So out of the load side now, we bring out our line conductor. So just got to make sure we get these in the right orientation. So we bring out our line conductor. We bring out our neutral conductor. And what we've done there is take a 2.5 millimeter squared cable now from the load side. Okay, so we go to the sockets and Matt now can turn them off. You can leave them permanently on if you wanted to, but Matt's got the ability at his door for his daughter to turn off those sockets he's worried about. He left the one on for like the TV and that because he didn't want to have to keep resetting the Wi-Fi. So it was a number of sockets that went from the consumer unit to a number of sockets on the A3 radio before he went through his double pole switch. And let's continue that onto another socket outlet as well. So again, in 2.5 millimeter squared, twin and CPC cable. We come across to our last socket outlet. So there we go. That's what Matt's done in his property in order that he can isolate some of the sockets that he's worried about. He did it using a 20 amp double pole switch. He wired an A3 radial with a 20 amp fuse with a 30 milliamp RCD. He took 2.5 millimeter squared cable to a number of sockets before passing it through the double pole switch, meaning you can isolate a number of sockets when he left the room or his daughter left the room.
Well, hopefully this idea of using an A3 radial circuit with a 20 amp breaker controlled from a switch. This time I'm coming into my son's bedroom, and we've done a very similar setup in here. So we have a 20 amp double pole switch here, and the light switches are just above it. And then in the room, we have a 13 amp double socket here. And then we have various 13 amp sockets behind his desk and underneath the desk. We also have a 13 amp socket up here. And as you can see, the TV is plugged into that. Now this TV, we will be eventually getting him a new TV, and that will be mounted up on the wall. And so again, that switch, that 20 amp double pole switch, won't control this socket. It will only control all of the other sockets that are in the room. So they can be just turned on and off as and when. Whereas the socket behind the TV will be permanently live, which means that it won't need to be reset every time the power has been turned on or turned off. So again, hopefully that's might give some good ideas for some of you guys that are doing some work on your houses.